Hello friends and welcome back. Friends, as we know that your exams are starting soon. So I thought, why don't I share some MCQ questions of Business Regulatory Framework of CYBCOM Semester 5. So accordingly, I have set some questions which are useful for you guys for writing your exam. So this one is just a part of practice MCQ. If you go through all the questions, definitely those questions will be useful for you guys for writing your examination. So please allow me to share my screen. And here is the screen. I hope you'll be able to see my screen. And the screen is here. So once again, I welcome you all to my official YouTube channel. And here, we are going to see. Okay, so I welcome you all to my official YouTube channel, that is Academic Insights. If you really like my video, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, as well as don't forget to press bell icon so that you'll get more videos in days to come. Similarly, also go for please like the video, as well as share my video, and don't forget to comment in chat box so that we can improve in days to come. So friends, I'm here to give some practice questions of Business Regulatory Framework, and here we are going to talk about topic number one, that is Indian Contract Act 1872. We have taken 20 more questions from this topic. We are going to see one more video, and there we are going to talk about another 20 questions. So friends, the first question is, the person making the proposal is called the, and the person accepting the proposal is called. So we are asking the person who is accepting the proposal and the person who is making the proposal, what sort of, you know, definition is there for these two? The options are proposer, proposee, promisee, promiser, promiser, promisee, proposee, proposer. And the correct option is promiser, promisee. Moving on to the question number two. And here we are going to see question number two. Every promise and every set of promises forming the consideration for each other is called as, the options are a wordable contract, a wide contract, an agreement. And the option is an agreement. Question number three, an agreement enforceable by law is called as a wordable contract, a wide contract, an agreement. The options are, these are the options. We are going to find out one correct option from this, and the correct option is a contract. Moving on to the question number four, and here we are going to see question number four in a detailed manner. An agreement which is enforceable by law at the option of other and others is dash, and the options are a wordable contract, a wide contract, and agreement. And these are the options, and from these options we have to find one correct option, and the correct option is a wordable contract. Next. The act which deals with matters relating to contract is titled as. So what is a act which deals with contract and contracts related matters? So what is the name of that act? The options are the Contract Act, Act 1872, the Indian Contract Act 1872, the Indian Contract Act 1882, the Indian Contract Act 1972. And the correct option is the Contract Act 1872. An engagement not enforceable by law is said to be, the engagement which is not enforceable by law is said to be, or what we call it, the options are a contract, void, voidable contract, or a void contract. And the options are void. Question number seven, in order to convert a proposal into a promise, the acceptance must dash be absolute and qualified, be expressed in some usual and reasonable manner, unless the proposal prescribes the matter in which it is to be accepted. C, B absolute and unqualified. And D, both B and C only. And the correct option is both B and C only. So this one is the correct option. Moving on to the next question, that is question number 8. A contract which ceases to be enforceable by law becomes void when it when it ceases to be void, voidable, enforceable, unenforceable. And the option is, the correct option is void. Question number 9. The Indian Contract Act 1872, which was enacted on 25th April 1872, came into force with effect from. So when this act is enforced in practice by the government, that we are going to see. The first option is 1st May 1872, 1st September 1872, 1st October 1872, 1st November 1872, and the correct option is 1st September 1872. An agreement was entered into with the miner. This agreement is void, voidable, bad, illegal, and the correct option is void. Question number 11. An agreement was entered into with the miner. This is agreement dash. The minor is not personally liable. Minor's estates are liable to make good. Minor's guardian is liable. The minor is personally liable. And the correct option is the minor is not personally liable. Consent is said to be free when it is not caused by. The options are very much influence, undue influence, slightly influence, and influence. And the correct option is undue influence. Question number 13. A being in debt to B, the money lender of his village contracts a fresh loan on terms which appears to be unconcisable. This will be termed as fraud, coercion, undue influence, misinterpretation. The options are fraud, co-coin, undue influence, and misinterpretation. And the correct option is undue influence. Number 14, when consent to an agreement is caused by co-coin, fraud, or misinterpretation, the agreement is a contract. Voidable at the post, options are voidable at the option of the party whose consent was so caused, illegal, depend upon the circumstances of the case, and the last one is void. And the correct option is first one, that is voidable at the option of the party whose consent was so caused. Question number 15, where both parties to any agreement are under a mistake as to a matter of fact essential to the agreement, and the options are the agreement is voidable, the agreement can't be enforceable at law, the agreement is void, the agreement is not void, and the correct option is the agreement is void. Question number 16, when consent to an agreement is caused by undue influence, the agreement is a contract. Bad, void, illegal, voidable, and the option is voidable. Question number 17, the agreements which are in restraint of trade are valid, illegal, void, voidable, and the option is void. The question number 18, the consideration must be adequate, need not be adequate, substantially adequate, and the correct option is need not be adequate. So that is not necessary, that should be adequate. So need not be adequate is the right option. Then question number 19, an agreement in restraint of the marriage of a major person is legal, illegal, void, or voidable, and the correct option is void. And the last question for this video, the consideration may be, options are past, present, future, all the options are correct. And the correct option is, all the options are correct. So here, we have taken 20 questions from question number, topic number 1, that is the Contract Act 1872. I hope you all have understood your questions, your answer questions with answers. And it is the right time to take a break here. We are going to meet in next video also. Till then, thank you very much. But at the time of leaving, don't forget to subscribe the channel, as well as don't forget to press the bell icon. Even you like the video, share the video among your friends and relatives and with your colleagues. And the last but not least, don't forget to write into the comment so that we can improve in days to come. So thank you very much. Here we take a break. Thank you and all the best for your exam. Thank you once again and all the best for your exam. Bye-bye.